certainly the start of sports. They've always taken the aspect of supporting the district in the wants category versus the needs category, meaning if the district says we have a need for a middle school program at the start of it, traditionally, they want to look at their bylaws and like that. I'm not sure that would fall under that auspices, because they've always said that the school department should provide appropriate funding for what you need to run that program. They come in and help out with additional stuff that's above and beyond what is needed to this sport. So I'm just kind of using the generic philosophy that they operate under, but I can't speak on behalf of them or within the rest of the board to take that conversation as a issue.
Superintendent, do you want to comment on this?
Well, I'd like very much to see every program we can have running at the middle school running. But I will defer to Mr. Tech as far as how that can all be scheduled. It's really if we have students participating after school, they can't both be on the track. So I'm not exactly sure how we would arrange that, or do we have something that the kids go home and then parents have to transport them back? Because I don't know how the middle school is compete with Barville and Smithfield. Is that all after school? Is that in the evening? What's the flexibility of the schedule?
So primarily the way we've always, and again, I'm just kind of speaking, you know, loosely, this is a general idea, that primarily we've always given consideration to starting the middle school practice right after, at 2:30, 2:15, to get them going right away, to minimize the amount of them, you know, going unsupervised per se, but for a long period of time. And traditionally, a lot of the middle school parents and middle school kids don't have a way back if they leave off the facility. And so the high school currently right now doesn't allow practice to begin until 3:15, and that's constituted right now. So we have kind of an hour of time where high school kids aren't available to start practicing yet. So as it stands right now, we've always used that first hour of the game for our middle school softball, baseball, for example, to get them out there. Middle school track meets and everything do start right around 3:30. They're primarily an afternoon events. They do get going right away. They're younger age, so they try to get those events go. Outdoor track, same thing, though, even at high school level, most of the meets start at 3:34, and a lot of the high school meets will start on the weekends. But middle school primarily is during the week, primarily around 3:30-ish, whatever time needed for the schools to transport to wherever they're going. And those meetings go usually about 3 hours or so. So middle school week goes from 3:30 to 6:30 or so.
So as far as the budgeting process for next year, Claire Arnold and myself will be meeting with every principal, every director, Matt, and we are going to try to the best of our ability to project out into next year to accommodate any of these initiatives in the budget. So we're going to look into, because we do not want to start something and then not be able to fund it. So we have to look at this in conjunction with everything else. I do like the fact that we're putting in home field facilities for track and field to offset some of the transportation. I mean, that will be very good. As far as for this year, I mean, if you want, we will look and we will see where the funding is. I don't know. This is looking at me. But I mean, we can have a comb through all the line items and see where we stand.
These are working on.
I can tell you.
I also will want to address at some point Matt's schedule. He hasn't stood up there and talked about himself as far as how much time he has allocated as we keep adding more and more programs. So I would like to take a look at his schedule and to see what we can do to sort of put more boots on the ground, hands available to help manage all of these students and all of these programs.
So, Mr. Tech, would it help you if we voted on this
do this, but understand that at the end of the day, if you come back and say it's $50,000, we may not do it.
Right, I think that would be a good sort of sign of faith as I move forward, some of those things, and then that you go out and start posting for potential job openings and that nature, and if they know that there's kind of a little letter of stand behind, so to speak, rather than just this concept that's out there, gives them a little more firm grasp to it. Again, obviously, with the caveat, and then final approval, that's fine, to accept the non-approval, that nature, but I think, yes, the answer to that question.
And just, I mean, and just for the record, I mean, you know, the outdoor shop for Dave, we're getting donations for, which is more than $6,000 we're talking about, will save far more than $6,000 in legal costs this year. That line item, I know, has been cut, but it, you know, these are things that we're doing to cut the budget, and it seems that this is a very important program. I agree with Mr. Shari, who say if kids, if they're on the track field, they can't be getting in trouble, hopefully. And they're not sitting on the couch playing video games, to be honest. I mean, so I think that's all a good thing. I'd like to push it. Obviously, if it was a call between, I'd love to see foreign language in the middle school. So if it was one versus the other, I might pick that. But because of the cost differential, I don't see this being a lot of money to stop this program. Service, you know, 40 kids, 50 kids, hopefully.
Struck
money.
In that aspect, there is a, you know, track does have that one tangible benefit, which is that as long as you get enough coaches in place, it's an unlimited roster. Something that's right, there are the tracks and cuts per se. That's only dependent on us having the ability to properly supervise and make sure that we have enough adults to represent and cover the amount of kids that are participating. So.
You know, I just want to say thank you, Ms. Jerry, for speaking about this, because I agree with you. This is a great program to try and bring in. You know, I think this is a good problem for us to have as a district. You know, we're trying to bring more athletic programs in. We're trying to do more for the kids. And, you know, I'm aware that there are challenges. I'm aware that there are hurdles to cross over. But I'm really feeling really encouraged about this. And unless there are any questions, I would like to make a motion. All right. I want to make a motion to have you proceed in good faith, stating that you are going to support this program. So long as you come back to us in a month with a report that makes this cost friendly. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
That's my opinion. And thank you.
Motion to be exact. Roll call. Does anybody have any further discussion on this? Are you ready?
Mr. Lombardi?
Yes.
Mrs. Joannes?
Yes.
Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Mrs. Mayo?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mrs. Lada?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0.
Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else want to comment on that issue? Oh, you're on.
Students enjoy doing, like me.
kids who are talented in athletics too, and can carry on a new future with it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ian Lujan, and I am a student at Boston Middle School. I want to talk to you about why growing our athletic program is important to me. I came to this middle school not being very athletic person. I wasn't really into sports before I came here. Then I started cross country and all that changed. I grew to love sports, and I want the same for future athletes. I want our athletic program to grow and have things that all kids can enjoy. I want kids to be impacted the same way I was. I think all kids want to be part of our athletic program. I think we should continue to grow our program and always try to better it, because I think the possibilities of the athletic program in the school are endless. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy my speech. Pretty soon, so I can wait for that.
my thoughts, I get frustrated when I see things being
put aside because they don't belong, and then the loop band hasn't belonged, so we put back on. The school district, City Valley's on, the school district is not, not new to the process. This is, some drawings from 2004, that was established from the sketch, the capital improvement program. So we worked on moving it. And we certainly were aware of the rolling projection, is in the 2008 NESDA projection, which kind of projected a decrease in enrollment, actually, to 2015. And so, to stabilize it, we want to get back on that. That's good news. If you don't need those rules, just give a moment, put in the panel. On the topic panel, I just like to point out a couple of things. Back in the design school, they said about it, it's been superintendent. And we ran through some numbers, you know, with the rest of the news, the net financial impact, would be about a $260,000 decrease in the operating budget. Which was kind of neat, right? At that time, using facilities we had, they were made in very tight control of the school, but it was approved. And we definitely not be having done that. Yeah. That's what's sort of happening in the whole existing situation on top of it. The school would be great, drive in. It makes a lot more sense. But the town, it seems to have this problem with planning, and just moving from one to another because one is going, one is going. After my short experience in business of over 30 years, I can point out the realities of continuing to do that. Number one, all this replanning does at least three things. The price and scope of anything that you can plan is going to increase. Conditions are going to continue to deteriorate. And G. Valley College, my experience is that every plan has a flaw. At least one. They don't toss the whole thing out. They take the good parts of the whole thing, or in this case, any one of the four plans, reaching back to the school district, the capital improvement plan, and the school district improvement, building improvement committee, and then the EDIC, the past Hollywood council plan, and their current plan. So, you know, I can actually count and try to remember this. You got four people on the draw. And stop, let's get moving. I'm shutting one down. I'd like to see it happen. So, guys, let's get this shit out of the way. The other thing I have what I want to mention is that this is something I think that we should just stick in our heads and remember. That when the Sioux Field and Ed Hathaway failed, first of all, I went on with one of our local contractors who does sewage work. And he was a couple of town, but they connect most of the residential business buildings to the sewer system. And I think that there is a sewer connection in business that helps in the same way. So we sat there with our